Hey, step inside that booth, get loose, knock out a nigga tooth, man. It is your boy, 503 Line, man, back at it again. Lunchtime hunt, hot boxing topics. Let's get right to it, man. So, my first video I made today was the Errol Spence versus Ugas situation. Wanted to go and get that out the way, man. But today, the second video of December 20th, 2021, I want to talk about potential and possible opponents for Terrence Crawford. Now, when you look at Terrence Crawford in his current situation, he's currently a free agent, meaning that he can freelance and renegade, shall I say, and pretty much render his services whatever best suits him. He is advised by MTK Global. And MTK Global has fighters on DAZN. They have fighters on PBC. They have fighters on Top Rank. So MTK does business with pretty much everybody. So with that being said, my first opponent that I want to bring to the table is none other than Jerron Boots Ennis. Jerron Boots Ennis versus Terrence Bud Crawford is a pay-per-view fight. Whoever was to pay for this fight, or whoever gets this fight on their network, could do pay-per-view. Bud just fought on pay-per-view versus Sean Porter. People would actually pay to see a prime Jerron Boots Ennis versus a prime Terrence Bud Crawford. Actual, factual. If people pay, if 100,000 people paid to see Porter and Terrence Crawford, I think almost 150,000 to 200,000 people would pay to see Jerron Boots Ennis. Jerron Boots Ennis fights in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Okay? He has people like Gilly the King, Wallow helping him and promoting him. Blood Crawford fights out of Omaha, Nebraska. So those fights can happen, man. And that would be you know, something to see, in my personal opinion. Now, when you look at when you look at the shock value, it's all up. My next person who I want to talk about that I don't see nobody talking about is Rashidi Speedy Ellis. I'm not sure if Rashidi Speedy Ellis is on Golden Boy DAZN anymore, but that fight is a great fight for Terrence Crawford as well. Nobody is talking about Rashidi Speedy Ellis. He's still a great, fast, fun, flashy fighter to watch as well. And I do think the speed of him would give Terrence Crawford problems. We've seen Terrence Crawford struggle with Gamboa. Would the Gamboa have hand speed? Amir Khan was giving Bud some work until he curled out and quit when he got hit with a low blow. Hand speed could be a problem for Terrence Crawford. Is this a pay-per-view fight? No. You know what I'm saying? Because people are really not interested in Rashidi Speedy Ellis. But I still think that's a good name, a good undefeated top guy at welterweight that doesn't get a lot of credit. Okay? And by the way, my first two guys who I picked them for a reason, because they don't have any fights coming up. Okay? The third guy is Virgil Ortiz Jr. Now, it's rumored to be that Virgil Ortiz Jr. has a fight coming up in January. I don't know too much about this guy. I'm going to do more research about his opponent. But he just signed with Probellum, some guy that Virgil Ortiz is supposed to be fighting. I would definitely do a video about that at a later time. But I would love to see Virgil Ortiz Jr. Virgil Ortiz Jr. currently fights on Golden Boy on DAZN. Like I say, Bud is signed to MTK. And they have plenty of fighters on DAZN. As a matter of fact, Virgil Ortiz is with MTK Global. So those are two people that's being managed and advised by the same company. Voila. Virgil Ortiz is number one in the WBO. He's not the mandatory yet. He's just number one. Okay. Could this fight be on pay-per-view? No. I would want to see this fight on the zone. Why? Because Virgil fights on the zone. Would that fight bring in more subscribers? Absolutely. Could they do it in Texas? Absolutely. Could they do it in Nebraska? Absolutely. That is a great fight for Terrence Bud Crawford. My next guy is Keith One Time Thurman. Thurman? Then duck me, son. Keith One Time Thurman is currently having a fight on the first week of February against Marios Barrios. Now, we all thought Keith Thurman would never return to boxing, but he's coming back. I don't think Errol Spence is going to entertain him to try to get his belts back from Errol Spence, which was the WBA and the WBC belt, which Errol Spence is about to fight for. So I think he should try to get the WBO belt off of Terrence Bud Crawford if he gets past and beats Marios Barrios, who's making his welterweight debut. Keith Thurman and Bud Crawford have history, as well as Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford. So I think that would be a great fight. Is that a pay-per-view fight? Yes, it is. Both these guys, they don't like each other. Keith Thurman is going to talk shit. Bud Crawford will talk shit. That is a pay-per-view fight. That will be big on PBC Fox. That's only if Bud Crawford comes to PBC and does business with the PBC. I think that they could use college football. They could use, the Nebraska Cornhuskers to promote that fight. That would be big in Omaha. So I do think Keith Thurman is a good fight for Bud Crawford. Now, one and my last and final opponent for Mr. Bud Crawford is none other than Josh Taylor. Josh Taylor, once again, is another MTK Global fight, and he's with Top Rank ESPN. Will Bud Crawford go back and do business with Top Rank ESPN? We don't know. That's a possibility. Should he fight Josh Taylor if he goes back to ESPN Top Rank? Yes. Is that a pay-per-view fight? No. It's not a pay-per-view fight. I think Josh Taylor is a great fighter, but Josh Taylor does not have that name value. If they put Josh Taylor and Bud Crawford on pay-per-view on ESPN Plus, it'll probably barely crack 100,000 like how Sean Porter and Terrence Crawford did. But it will be a big fight on ESPN. I think it does 4 to 5 million homes on regular ESPN easy. Josh Taylor, he wants the Bud Crawford fight. Could they make that fight happen? Could they do a one fight deal with Josh Taylor and Terrence Crawford? Absolutely. With all of the guys I named on the back end, from Virgil, Keith to Josh, all have fights coming up. So that's why I put them last. Now, the two guys who I mentioned in the beginning of the video, Boots and Rashidi Speedy, they don't have fights. So we shall see what's next for Bud Crawford. Bud Crawford does have options. It's not the end all be all if Bud Crawford and Errol Spence don't fight next, bro. I just gave you five guys, my top five guys, right, who I want to see Bud Crawford fight next, okay? Jerron Boots Ennis, Rashidi Speedy Ellis, okay? Virgil Ortiz Jr., Keith Thurman, and Josh Taylor. That's five guys. I'm not mad if he fights Josh Taylor. I think that's a good fight, a good name on the resume. Keith Thurman, a good fight, good name on the resume. Virgil Ortiz, a good fight, good name on the resume. Rashidi Speedy Ellis, good fight, good name on the resume. Jerron Boots Ennis, good fight, good name on the resume. Bud Crawford has options. You Bud Crawford fans, stop acting like Errol Spence is the end-all, be-all, bro. Because he's not, bro. He's not the end-all, be-all, man. But y'all let me know what y'all think about my list. Y'all give me y'all top five lists in the comment section. And we will continue to have this conversation respectfully. And let's just build on this, man. You know what I'm saying? It's not the end of the world, man. Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford will fight, you know what I'm saying, when Errol Spence gets the third belt. Period. So, y'all let me know what y'all think about the video. Smash the like button. Leave a comment down below. And also, follow my social media handles on the outro, man. It's your boy 503 Line, man. Mr. Smoke City. I'm up out of here, y'all. Peace out.
I'm still Adrian the Problem Bronner, the Can Man. Anybody can get it. Africans, I just beat the fuck out of a Mexican.
Boy, just be yourself. If people don't like it, if you're being yourself, fuck them. Message.